Space can be beautiful. You have flawless elliptical galaxies with no traces of dust bands blocking the view of their stunning shape. You have grand galaxies with spiral arms that wrap around the entire galaxy with a surprising level of symmetricity. And then you have the Arp Catalogue, or the Atlas of Peculiar Galaxies. These are galaxies which laugh in the face of order, galaxies which are often going through a very tumultuous time in their existence, and they are fantastic in their own right, each with a story to tell. I'm Alex McColgan, and you're watching Astrum, and in this Hubble episode, we will go through some of the most peculiar galaxies that Hubble has ever seen, and I'll try and explain what it is you are looking at. Number 43, Arp 116, or Messier 60. At first glance, this galaxy doesn't look so unusual. It seems like a standard elliptical galaxy, a massive galaxy which has already used up most of its dust and gas in creating stars, which gives it this smooth appearance. It can be found 57 million light years away, and has one of the biggest black holes ever discovered near its center, at roughly 4.5 billion solar masses. But this isn't particularly peculiar so far. Zooming out a bit reveals something very unusual. M60 is right next to another, very different looking spiral galaxy called NGC 4647. From our viewpoint, it looks like the galaxies should be interacting with each other, but there aren't any immediate signs of this. This is very unusual, to see two galaxies so close, but without any warping of their shape. As it turns out, they are not side by side, but rather one is in front of the other. There's one other really unique thing in this image, another galaxy you probably haven't noticed. This tiny little galaxy here is known as M60 UCD1. It is the most densely packed galaxy that we know of, being only 300 light years across, but having 200 million solar masses contained within it. Towards the center of this tiny galaxy, stars are so densely packed, it makes the density of stars about 15,000 times greater than found in Earth's neighborhood in the Milky Way, meaning that the stars are about 25 times closer together. An X-ray view of the surrounding area from the Chandra telescope reveals all the black holes and neutron stars found in Messier 60, and as you can see, this tiny galaxy also has an X-ray source, indicating there is also a black hole to be found at the center. Scientists believe that this is a black hole with roughly 10 million solar masses, which would make it just a bit bigger than the black hole found at the center of our Milky Way galaxy. If this is the case, it is thought that this galaxy used to be much bigger, but most of its mass was stripped away, leaving just this dense cluster of stars found near the center. Number 44, Arp 147, or IC 298. You don't have to look too closely at this image to determine that this is a very weird looking galaxy. It is in fact a pair of galaxies that have collided, found roughly 440 million light years away. This is what the previous galaxies could end up looking like if they ever collide, because the left galaxy is an elliptical galaxy and the one on the right is a spiral galaxy. The collision, estimated to have happened 40 million years ago, caused the spiral galaxy to undergo extreme star formation, seen in the bright blue regions. The most active time of star formation, or starburst, was 15 million years ago, and would have produced the most massive types of stars. But due to these stars being short-lived, lasting only tens of millions of years, most of the biggest ones have already died as exploding supernova and become either neutron stars or black holes. This reddish part of the ring appears to be the original nucleus of the galaxy, now just a segment of the ring. Due to elliptical galaxies having exhausted most of their supply of dust and gas, Star formation isn't nearly as prevalent in this galaxy. What you can see, though, is the effect of tidal forces causing a ripple or a shockwave through the galaxy, which you can see as the stars have clumped into rings. Number 45, ARP 77, or NGC 1097. Another galaxy with a smaller galaxy tucked away inside it is NGC 1097. Unfortunately, the Hubble image cuts the smaller galaxy out, but ESO's Very Large Telescope has also had a look at the galaxies, in which you can see its smaller neighbor, NGC 1097A, a small elliptical galaxy that is in orbit around the bigger galaxy. NGC 1097 itself looks quite like a giant eyeball to me, with its pupil surrounded by a bright iris. Zooming in on the iris, we can see that it is a ring rich in star-forming regions. Each of the bright blobs are thought to be hot bubbles of hydrogen in which stars are forming. Viewing different wavelengths of light shows that some dust from the rings is also being sucked in towards the supermassive black hole found in the galaxy center. But this isn't the most peculiar thing about NGC 1097. Zooming all the way out reveals four jets emanating from the core of the galaxy in an X shape. Due to the lack of hydrogen gas found in these jets, scientists believe that they are the remains of a small galaxy that NGC 1097 cannibalized. Number 46, ARP 142. Here is another galaxy merger that kind of looks like a penguin and an egg. When viewed like this, this image might seem serene almost. But in fact, the bigger spiral galaxy has taken a beating from this merger. This long section here is where one of the spiral arms of the galaxy has been ripped away by the elliptical galaxy, which doesn't look like it's too phased by this collision, other than the fact that it looks quite oblong in shape. Again, the blue regions along the edges here contain starburst, and this 3D view shows that these dust lanes are probably becoming detached from the galaxy too. These galaxies are found roughly 350 million light years away. Number 47, ARP 210, or NGC 1569. Now, I don't think you've seen a galaxy quite like this one. Well, that's because this tiny galaxy, no bigger than the large Magellanic Cloud orbiting our Milky Way galaxy, is pretty much just one giant nebula. This galaxy is almost the total opposite of an elliptical galaxy, as it is rich in gas and dust that has not yet formed stars. NGC 1569 is found near the Maffei group of galaxies, and due to its close proximity to these much bigger companions, the gas and dust within it has recently been compressed, causing rapid starburst at a rate 100 times faster than anything observed in our own Milky Way. Towards the center are densely packed, massive stars, which have blasted away the red dust and gas towards the outskirts of the galaxy through solar wind and supernova explosions, leaving behind huge star clusters. The small white stars found in the halo of the galaxy are older stars which have been around for much longer. We can have such a detailed look at this galaxy because although it is small, no bigger than 6,000 light years across, it is also reasonably close to us at only 11 million light years away. Number 48, ARP 272. We'll finish with one more galaxy merger seen from a rather interesting angle. These two galaxies are roughly the same size and are just astronomical moments away from impacting each other. There's also a third galaxy found just above them, which is also in on the action. The reason for seeing three galaxies merging at the same time could be due to the fact this is happening in the Hercules supercluster, roughly 500 million light years away, which is one of the biggest filamentary structures of galaxies that we know about in the universe. You see, the observable universe, as far as we can tell, kind of looks like a giant web, where galaxies band together to form these filaments, which form the boundaries between large voids in the universe. This is what the universe up to 500 million light years from us looks like. And even in this space, you can see this banding of galaxies. And just because some of you have asked about this in the past, this is where Bootes Void is, which is one of the biggest voids of galaxies that we know about. Well, thanks for watching. Every day, Brilliant publishes several daily challenges that provide a quick and fascinating view into a variety of math and science. Here's one that caught my eye recently, about how the universe didn't always used to be transparent. Brilliant not only explains why, but their platform also allows you to apply what you've learned with a problem at the end. Each problem comes with illustrations, animations, or interactive visualizations that really help you to grasp the concept and supply you with all the context you need to solve the problem yourself. If you like the problem and want to learn more, there's a related course that explores the same concept in greater detail. So, if you want to actively learn fascinating concepts each day, head over to brilliant.org/astrum and finish your day a little smarter. The first 200 of you to do so will get 20% off the annual premium subscription, so you can view all the daily challenges in the archives and unlock dozens of problem-solving courses. Well, I hope some of these images have impressed you as much as they impressed me. If you are new to the channel and want to see more Hubble images, check out the playlist here. Also, a big thank you to my patrons who support the channel. I couldn't do it without you. If you want to support the channel in other ways, then please like and share these videos to get the word out. All the best, and see you next time.